Hi guys, this is Ryan, the anomalous ambassador of the airwaves, bringing you a snippet from a patron episode, an update on what's taking place in Peru. If you want to hear all the content behind the paywall, please head on over to heroparanormal.com for less than the price of a boutique cup of coffee a month. You can access all the content behind the paywall, and there's a ton of it. Also, you can get that at Patreon if you go and search for Hero Paranormal. If you're listening to this on YouTube, please like, share, and subscribe the podcast. Unfortunately, it's the only way that I will be able to break through the algorithm of control. I will most likely never be monetized on YouTube for a variety of reasons, including the truth, and that will help me. The shadow ban is real. Enjoy this snippet. Hey guys, Ryan here, the anomalous ambassador of the airwaves, bringing you epic information today having to do with the activities in Peru. It's not the information I was hoping for, but it's the information I've received. That information is not good. It appears that the new U.S. Friendly president of Peru, who is one who removed the previous president last year and imprisoned him without due process, has nationalized the mining interests there. And he is the same president who has invited the U.S. Special Forces, Space Force, and other military segments of our military-industrial complex down for a project known as 2023 Sentinel. Now, he is, in fact, being protested pretty heavily in the streets. In fact, 11,000 police have been let loose to keep these protesters who are protesting what's taking place in Peru under control. And it appears as if there could be a correlation between all of the military presence that has gone down to Peru. This started in June, prior to all of these alien encounters by villagers in the Iquitu tribe, villagers who live in the Alto Nanay region, north of Lima, Peru. And this is the area that is being targeted. They have had an array of encounters and experiences with entities they don't understand. Some are purporting these entities may have tendrils of cooperation to some of the military elements that have gone down to the area, namely the Navy base nearby downriver. So, breaking news, it's not pretty. It's not what I wish was taking place. I was hoping for this to be a very much cleaner operation.
Until next time, keep your eyes to the skies, feet on the ground, but don't forget to take a look around.
Come blast off in my time machine. Third eye feeling like an Evazine. Blast off, blast off, blast off, blast off. Come blast off in my time machine. Third eye feeling like an Evazine. Blast off.